July 2014. These children are refugees from South Sudan. They live in Lechuar camp in Ethiopia, and they're being vaccinated against cholera. It looked so quick and easy, but to get here necessitated setting up a flawless organization, which began over 700 kilometers away at Addis Ababa Airport.
The problem in the field and why we are transporting with this cold chain truck is the main reason is in the field, they couldn't manage to find a cold storage place, which is reliable, plus which has a good backup. So we decided to put it here and to transport it to the field directly as like active cold chain.
This example is a good illustration of the obstacles to vaccinating during humanitarian emergencies. Natural disasters, population displacements, they all have their own specific requirements.
As new vaccines become available, we mustn't limit ourselves to just emergency immunization against measles. Once we've conducted a risk assessment in the targeted area, we need to integrate other vaccines. Immunization in an emergency situation is important not only to contain the risk of epidemics like measles and cholera, but also to reduce the burden of infectious diseases that can be prevented by vaccination. For example, whooping cough, a pneumococcus or haemophilus respiratory infection.
Most vaccines are administered as part of routine immunization for babies and children. But even here, issues with access to healthcare, the cost of vaccines, and the need to keep them cold right up to the time of administration pose challenges that result in 1 in 5 of the world's children being denied the immunization they so badly need.
We're using more and more vaccines, and they take up a lot more room in the cold chain. So now we would like them to be less heat sensitive and to have more flexibility with the cold chain. Just over a year ago, MSF and Epicentre conducted an efficacy study on the tetanus vaccine in Chad. The study showed that a vaccine could be stored for 30 days at under 40 degrees and will still be effective.
MSF is also exploring new ways of associating immunization with other preventive measures.
Up until now, in many countries, vaccination was proposed separately. Families would come with their child to see the vaccinator. This year in Chad, we chose to associate immunization with seasonal malaria prevention. So we didn't just target children in the 0 to 11 month age range, but included older children too. The fact that we associated vaccination enabled us to vaccinate over 50% of children aged 0 to 11 months and provide immunization coverage for 20-30% of children who hadn't been able to complete their vaccinations before the age of 1 year.
Back to Ethiopia and the children from South Sudan. So now they're protected against cholera, but there are other threats to their health. Several months later, MSF decided to protect them against respiratory infections. These efforts demonstrate MSF's determination to increase the number of vaccines it can provide during emergency operations. As in Ethiopia, thousands of Ugandan children were given the PCV vaccination in 2014 to reduce the risk of pneumonia. But campaigns like these are all too rare, because the cost of the pneumococcal vaccine is far too high, $21 for 3 doses, and that's the best-case scenario.